and welcome to my channel. Today I finally have a new art tutorial for you. I know it's been a while. Yeah, this one is actually surprisingly easy, so let's get started. As always, I'm starting off with an acrylic nail. Alternatively, you could do this on your natural nails and just apply a matte top coat or a matte nail polish or something. Just because the more rough texture will help the paint to not slide around as much, look more opaque, be easier to work with and prevent a whole lot of frustration. Yeah, as you can tell, there is still dark acrylic beneath the new layer of clear that I put on because I couldn't be bothered to file it all off. So I'm starting off with a white base, just so the colors are really gonna pop afterwards. So yeah, just apply the white paint, let it dry, then move on to colors. Alternatively, you could just use a pale color to begin with. If you're just building a nail for this or putting on a matte top coat on your natural nail for this, start off with a pale color. It saves a little bit of work. But yeah, anyway, this works as well. I was trying to sort of envision the colors of a dragon. I know those don't exist, so you can pretty much do anything you want. But I went for yellow and green and blue as my colors. But yeah, you could obviously just do whatever colors you want. I don't know, make it fit your clothing or whatever. Doesn't matter. And just apply them in an ombre. To merge the colors together, I'm basically just tapping the brush into the paint. It's harder to mix paint, I feel, than to mix like eyeshadows, to blend eyeshadows. But yeah, just keep messing around with it until it looks good. And keep in mind, we're gonna paint scales over top of this, so it's not like you're going to see the ombre in full detail. So yeah, don't be too perfectionistic. As long as it looks decent, it's fine. Then once it's dry, it's time to start on the scales, or at least, you know, you can tell from my blue paint that it's not fully dry yet, but as long as it's dry enough that you won't drag the bottom layers around when you apply the scales, is fine. I'm just using the very tiniest brush for this that I have. My brushes are actually from eBay, they're really cheap to begin with, but I also chopped this one up so it has about 3 hairs left. And I dampened it a little with water before putting it in the paint, just so the paint is as runny and thin and smooth going as possible. Just because, you know, the smoother this is. Like, the smoother the paint is, the thinner you can make the lines, and that's really, really what makes this look. Then you could leave it as is, or you could add a little bit more detail. I wanted to add a little bit more detail, so I'm putting a highlight just with white paint on top of just some random scales. Just, you know, like some of them are more shiny than others, the light is hitting them, that sort of thing. I don't know, I just think it makes it look a little bit more lively. Don't go overboard with this, you don't want to like make half the scales pure white. Just, you know, every now and then just give a scale a little bit of a highlight. And then once that's done, it's really important to let everything dry properly, because after this we're going to do the top coat and you don't want the paint to still be damp, because then you're going to make streaks and all and just mess it all up with the brush of the top coat, which would be tragic at this point. So yeah, the top coat I'm going to use is a gel top coat, a shiny one. It does last longer than a normal top coat. Just keep in mind, if you're doing this on your natural nails, do make sure if you use a gel top coat that you use one that's safe to use on your natural nails. Mine is not, so keep that in mind. Mine is specifically formulated for fake nails, so yeah. And then we're done. So here's the final result. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my videos, I actually mostly do makeup tutorials, then you can always subscribe to my channel. For now, as always, thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!